Any Greeks watching, don't take any offense, but.
Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Let's Talk. Today we will be discussing cultural food because I think we all agree to disagree that Arab food is the superior.
Yeah, we disagree.
No,
this is great. Interesting.
I think I meant we'd agree to. Yeah, we agree that Arab
food. We agree to disagree that it's not the best.
I think it really is.
Like, I don't think so.
No, but what?
I think we laid the foundation for everyone. And then all these cultures took like one thing and just like, yeah, we'll make this really good.
Yeah.
And then we'll claim
they
it.
Added, name
like,
one, name one.
They added like some herbs like, oh yes,
name one
like
thing.
Salt bay. See, no, you Turks, man, you add some salt.
What?
Name one thing Uzbeks
bro,
talk for
it's
me,
fashion,
guys.
Bro.
Nothing, fam.
I think a lot.
No.
I can't think right now.
I think it's just a...
I don't know Uzbek food. I know Uyghur food.
No, you've had Uzbek food.
I haven't had
Uzbek food. From the things you've had, from the things you... What? I missed something.
I said I haven't had Uzbek food. I've had Uyghur food. I mean, no, but for real though, like, where's the Uzbek food?
No, like polo.
I had polo, but
that's... Oh, you've had
samsa. Samsa.
Yeah.
No, that's not. It's not
yeah, it is like... good. Yeah, it's good.
Okay, it's good. Polo is original.
But there's
first of all,
polo. It's a
you guys have polo.
Yeah, yeah,
we call it pilaf. It's just rice.
Yeah, exactly.
Like we don't have a specific.
Yeah, no,
all the rice we have is pilaf.
But I think
is that the butter? Yeah,
they put
the
butter. But it's any rice we have, it's pilaf.
No, I think Turks just stole the most food from everyone. You guys
no,
stole,
these
you guys
were
like
Rabah,
the demos.
Rabah. We didn't steal kenafe.
You stole baklava from the Greeks.
What?
You stole baklava.
Bro, are you good?
Is baklava Greek?
It is not. What do you mean?
I prefer not to say, but I think it's very obvious what I think.
No, I reckon Kanaf is like
bro.
Turk, proper Turk.
And then you can't even... Bro.
No, I don't want it, bro. You guys can have... But kebabs... Oi, kebabs and baklava... Yes, you can't take... And Turkish coffee, bro.
Kebabs.
Turkish coffee, you can't
kebabs.
Take...
These guys...
Hey,
wait, we'll get to that. Hold on, we'll get to that. Just explain to everyone, like people that don't know what knafe is.
Wait.
One by one, yeah? Knafe.
Nablus. I don't care, fam.
Nablus is a town in Palestine, okay? That's where it originated from, because of the cheese and because of who made it.
Mm.
Where are you coming? These guys are
but
making...
But who said that? I want to point something.
They put like the thing on top and bottom.
Bro, you guys microwave it.
Oh,
I went to a restaurant with this one.
One restaurant microwave their kanafe.
Yeah,
I'm like, bro, take me to the best kanafe place in
Melbourne. Where was that?
I don't know where, but like
nah,
you took me to a
place.
Those
are Lebanese.
No, they always microwave it. At the end of the day, when it's not fresh, what are they gonna do? Put it in the oven again?
Yeah, bro, can't just.
What,
like
kanafe isn't yours. It never was.
I don't want to take it. Bro.
Okay, get away from that one dish.
Okay.
A whole general cultural food.
I agree.
You know that it's like Uzbeks.
What do you mean Uzbek?
Alright, let me... History lesson. The Turks came from the Central Asia, Uzbekistan area, went all the way to the Arabs, took some of their food, right? Like, with our food, got our food, took some of their food, and then settled in, like, Istanbul and places like that, right?
Interesting.
Right?
I'm not even kidding. Like, we're talking about the Turkish coffee, yeah? I swear, every single Turk says Arabic coffee is better than Turkish. It's stronger... It's better for coffee, that real coffee drinkers. Bro.
Stronger? Bro, how stronger are you going to get after Turkish coffee?
Everything of theirs, like tea, coffee, it's always weak.
Yeah, I know.
It's so weak.
The stronger it is doesn't mean the better.
No.
I don't like strong
but,
coffee.
Yeah, but real coffee drinkers, they sometimes prefer stronger coffee or meat. But their coffee is sweet, like really sweet.
It's not.
You guys can't say that, like... You guys claim tea as well, right? Like Turkish tea and stuff like
that. I don't personally claim
tea's from India.
Tea's from India.
Yeah.
But then Turks be like, oh no, tea.
Well, the thing is, right? Tea, right?
But coffee.
Where like you could have Lebanese tea, you could have Uzbek tea, and you could have Turkish tea. It's wherever you grow it.
No.
Where's Palestinian tea?
Huh? All right, go for it.
No, where's Palestinian tea?
Sorry.
You see, you have
like,
right? The best tea. Is out of the
but
them
my point being
the Uzbek cups
my point being tea
in a bowl
in a bowl that's the best tea man
that is bro I was like first time I came to Adelaide my dad took me to a restaurant I think it was Uyghur or
Uzbek.
I don't know anyway They brought the bowls and I'm just staring at it. I'm like, Dad, is this some? What are we supposed to do with this? And he's like, oh, you drink
tea. He doesn't know his roots. He doesn't know his, like, my roots? The root of his culture.
Bro, what do you mean?
This was back.
So, bro, that's not in my culture, drinking from a bowl.
Yeah, but yeah, no, you guys adapted from them.
No lie, but like, actually tastes like nice. Like, it
does.
Of course. Water. Bro, like, look, bro, and bro, before all of this, like, as if you haven't tried drinking water from a bowl. It tastes so much better.
I'm going to throw another tool in the shed, bro. Afghan food is nice as well. Afghan food's amazing.
Afghan kebab, that's
food.
It.
No, like in general, all the Afghan food.
Their rice is dry.
Their rice with the sultanas.
Sultanas add it a little sweet. Nah,
but see, the restaurants aren't as good, but if you actually know someone as Afghan and have it, it's
I reckon what turns off all this is how they how people try to imitate
Australian food. That's right.
How people try to imitate it. Like, none of the foods you got here is the same as
overseas. But yeah.
What is actually Australian?
So you can't
veggie.
But what's that? I reckon it's like burgers and stuff. Just the classic pasta.
That's not Australian, you know. That's Russian. I've never had it, but
it sounds Russian. To be honest,
I've never had it.
It sounds Russian.
Pavlova. Yeah, that's Russian, fam.
I think we'll agree to disagree there.
No.
That what? That baklavas and whatever claimed.
It's about the general, like, who's got the best food taste? Which culture has the best food taste?
Oh, yeah.
And you know that's us.
No, 100%. But you don't add as many, like, flavors and spices into it.
Instead of that, I'd say...
Kentucky Fried Chicken? Yeah. You actually took it from the Arabs, bro. I'm not even kidding. That's how many spices and herbs you add.
Nah.
11, bro.
Nah.
Bro, the secret recipe. Where do you think it originated from?
Like, you guys don't put enough oil.
Sit's house, bro.
No, you guys don't put enough oil, fam.
Bro,
so these guys are like, oh, more the better. Just, you know, chuck the whole thing.
You need like an oil chaser.
It's like, have you seen? It's like just one shot of vodka. It's like.
You need like an oil change like once a year. That's how much oil you
have. The oil filter's like,
bro, it became greasy. It became greasy, good. Bro. No, like, it's so rich in flavor. Come on, you gotta admit, like, even our rice, like, rice, bro, they have, what's it called?
Saffron. You guys use, like, a lot of nuts.
Bro, saffron, bro, they put saffron in the rice. Do you know how, bro, saffron, right?
What?
Saffron is, like, the thing
with saffron. Yeah, I know.
See, I think it's safe to say Arab food is the
best.
I'm not gonna agree with that.
Why?
Huh?
Why?
There's so many other cultures out there. You haven't tried them, so you can't just be like, oh.
Okay. Asia, right?
It's just like saying, oh, Krispy Kreme donuts are the best out of everyone, but you haven't tried any other donuts.
Good argument.
You know what I mean? Like, no, you haven't tried Dunkin' Donuts. You don't know how they go.
Can I tell you something? I've had Arab food from Arab country, and I've had Uzbek food from my country. And I can tell you that my food's better.
I've had it from your country. You told me.
You're gonna start a war, bro.
You told World me War III, guys. Was the best chicken you've ever had in your life, and that and
right, no, that's chicken.
Is made by a Palestinian. It right. originated from past.
Talking about cultural food.
Yeah, that's
fried chicken.
That's fast food.
Exactly.
No, it's
more fried chicken. It's not cultural food. I've had mansaf.
That's nice.
That pizza thing with onions in it.
Oh,
I've had intestines with
stuffed intestines.
Maqluba,
oh, knafe, shawarma, falafel.
Yeah, bro, I've had everything.
Okay, come on. Right? You're telling me something is better than falafel or bro, you can't.
Come to my country.
You just like
we'll treat you, fam.
You just like what are you gonna feed me?
I'm not telling you.
Other than polo,
it's a surprise.
Other than polo, I'm
gonna feed you.
No, there's polo, there's somsa. There's Monte. All
right, there's let's start from this side, right? Let's start from this. Wait, what's Afghan? No. Monte's thing. No, it's either Korean Chinese. Or Chinese. Yeah, yeah. It's dumplings or dumplings.
It's dumplings.
No, but starting from this side, I reckon we state one of your favorite, like, best dish.
All right, go.
And then we'll decide from there.
But there's so much to choose in
Darren. You gotta choose, if you were to choose one right now, what would you choose?
Like, to eat right now?
Yeah, yeah. And it's from your country.
No, not for you to eat, but like, what dish would you give everyone?
Yeah.
Because you might have like a specific taste.
Mm.
there's a lot, I'm not gonna lie.
But like with all cultural food, it's an acquired taste. So like,
no, do you have one big dish that like
that's like hella well known? No,
because
we have polo.
Yeah, but
we first of all, it's not polo, it's osh. Uzbeks call it osh. That's it. I don't know where polov came. It might be called polov somewhere else.
You guys stole it from the Turks, but continue.
One thing I think is Arab food, there's such a big range and variety. It's like going into like a candy store as a kid, bro.
Yeah, bro, like Lebanese food is different to Jordanian food, Palestinian food,
different flavors, bro. Like Iraqi food. It'll be endless. Like if you put Arab food, it's not like a section, bro. It's like a whole store. Like, there's so much to it.
That's with
you can't. It's like
because you guys are
like Turks,
Turkey,
continue.
Greek,
continue. France,
all these little places you guys pick and choose.
What do we get from Turkey?
Yeah, we're definitely scrapping after this is over.
What do we get from Turkey? One thing we get from Turkey. Tell me one thing we get from Turkey.
One thing.
Or like Greek.
Bro, one thing. Greece. Bro, I'll be listening for days, bro.
Baklava.
Bro, what do you mean?
I told you, I gave you kebab and baklava. Bro, I don't want anything to do with it. Anything sweet with nuts, you can have it.
But the thing is,
shawarma is a replica of their kebabs.
No, but... Shawarma is completely different from your
kebabs. It's a replica.
No, you guys...
It's not even that. We actually have shawarma as well.
All right. Okay.
Yeah, but Greeks would claim it as euros.
Okay. It's fast food.
Greeks watching, don't take any offense, but I'm not going to say it. No, sorry.
Okay, you can have baklava. Shawarma,
the thing is, I don't know much Jordanian foods.
Exactly, you can't claim.
I can't claim them, but the ones I already know.
Like what? I'm not Jordanian, by the way. I'm Palestinian. Yeah. So
you don't know much Arab food in general.
I mean, like, yeah, like both. Yeah, Arab, but like, but still, I don't know. Like, I can't really judge. But looking at it, it's,
You know what we should do?
What?
We're gonna do this for them. We're gonna have one dish. You bring a dish. You bring a dish, and we'll bring a dish, and we'll have a taste test, and you decide which one you like.
Ah, killer!
But no one knows where the originated from, and not just us. Like we'll get.
But you're already gonna be able to
like
tell
10-20 people. No, 10-20 people.
No, but it's like a disadvantage.
What?
Because my mom's like the best chef in Adelaide.
Bro,
look, I don't doubt she's a good cook, but you're biased because you're like.
Bro, I swear you were saying
that. We'll do it. 100% we'll do it.
We'll do it.
I swear.
But
you guys are waiting for them, and they'll see that Arab food is the best.
You guys are wasting your time.
For now, let's wrap it up. That's all for today. Catch us next time.
Our food's the best.
Let's talk. No, it's not.
Good stuff.
Arab food.
Uzbek.
Arab food.
Uzbek.
One last... Wait.
Leave in the comments.
Wait. One last thing. Tell us in the comments, what's your favorite food?
Mm-hmm.
What country doesn't have to be yours? Tell us what food you prefer. You have $10. Where would you spend it? All right, catch $10? Us later.
That's it.
That's the budget. All right. Anyways, catch us later on another episode of Let's Talk. Ciao. See ya. Bye. Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Let's Talk. Today, the topic of discussion is cultural food.
Continue. I thought you finished, sorry. Oh, bad. Continue.
No, it's good.
That's all good. Keep it. It's from the start. Bloopers, man. Bloopers. This guy.
No, bro. You meant to keep him so it's more original.
All right. Three. Hey, guys. Welcome back.
Quick,
camera. Let's go, bro.
Let's check
this.
Stop laughing, fam.
Go.
Bloopers.
Oh, yeah.
3, 2, 1. Hey, guys. Welcome back to another episode of Let's Talk. The topic of discussion today would be...
Food.
I do forget. All right, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, my God.